It's a special day. We are all here to honor Mr. Srinivasan and the India Cements Company. And before I start off, you know, I would like to say a big thanks to all the people behind sitting in the blue shirt. They're part of the company, and without their hard work, of course they have a great leader, but without their hard work it would have been very difficult to take the company where it is right now. And if India Cements was not doing well, there won't be any CSK, which means I won't be standing here. So thanks a lot to all of you. In my mind, I made this speech 3 or 4 times and I had to delete it every time. So I was like, I'm not going to make a speech again, you know, I'll just go with the motion and see what really is happening and we take it forward from there. The only advantage is being the youngest, you know, often you don't really need to speak in a particular order. You need to just speak out your heart and what is relevant. So I would talk more about the interaction that I had with Mr. Srinivasan and the company. I think the first interaction was, I remember it was during a test match and he became the treasurer. And he comes in and Kashi sir is with him, and it was, I think, lunch or tea or stumps, and he just inquired about the payment, you know, as to when do you get the payment, you know, you play the games and matches. And one of our cricketers said, sir, if you are lucky, we get it after 4 months. He just looked around, Kashi sir was behind, like, Kashi, why is it that they have to wait 4 months for their payment? Kashi sir didn't say anything and it was looked after there. So that was the start. A lot of us know him as a great administrator, his passion for the sport. He's somebody, you know, which is written in the books also. He started with lawn tennis. You know, he was a very good player of lawn tennis. The company supported a lot of different sports, ball badminton being one of them. A lot of you may not have heard about ball badminton. I was employed with the railway, so I know the sport because, you know, you get employment in ball because of ball badminton, railways also. It's a very interesting sport. Then you move further to table tennis, you go to chess, cricket, of course, we all know. And I think there's one sport that he, I wouldn't say loves more than cricket. I think it's something that he loves to play more than cricket, and that is golf. And that has been his association, you know, with golf throughout. I've had various interactions with him. I got to learn a lot out of him. You know, the interactions has been very friendly, you know, because I was part of CSK for the longest of time and I got enough time with him. You know, 2 months you are sitting in Chennai, so on and off whenever the team is going through a rough phase, which was, apart from the last season, always the case. You know, we crawled into the knockout stage somehow and, you know, we managed to do what we did. So a lot of interactions were about how we don't mind the opposition winning the game. We don't want to lose the game. So he's someone who plays it very hard, but plays it fair. And that's why the very first edition when we selected the team, in my mind, I was like, I want to win the fair play trophy, you know, because I always felt you can play hard, but at the same time, you can play fair and win tournaments. We couldn't win the tournament, but, you know, always we featured in the fair play trophy. And the irony is last year, again, when we selected the team, we had Watson in the team. He's not here, so I have the liberty of saying this story. So he's somebody, you say something to him, he reacts very quickly. And a lot of cricketers are smiling. They know what really I mean. So after a while, I met Mr. Srinivasan. I was like, sir, this time we don't have a chance of winning the fair play trophy. I don't think we'll be in the top 2 or 3 also. So like, what's the reason behind it? You know, like, we have got a fair amount of cricketers who are very aggressive, you know, Watson being one of them, but I'm not worried about him. The person I'm really worried about is Mr. Ambati Raidu. So he asked me, why do you say that? He's a perfect guy. I was like, yes, he's a perfect guy. The only problem is when he's batting. If he thinks it's a no ball or a white ball before, and if the umpire has not given it, he just turns and his hand either goes like that or he goes like this. Srivai is laughing because he must be the match referee in a few of those games. But I think with Srini sir, it has been a very special bonding. You know, I never knew I'll get selected for CSK. I never asked the obvious reasons why I got selected for CSK, but coming from where I came, and it gave me an opportunity to understand the culture of South India, and that's why it became a very perfect mix of, I know there are quite a few children over here, but you know, it's like rum and coke, you know, on their own they are very different, but once you mix them, they are very different. So all the aggression and everything came from where I was born and brought up, but you know, coming to South, understanding the culture, it made me believe in myself, and you know, it made me a bit more conservative, but at the same time, you know, it pushed me to play hard cricket and fair cricket at the same time. A lot of people have different views about me, about him, and to end it, you know, I would just, some wise man once said, you know, either you love him or you hate him, but you can't ignore him. So all of us, I think majority of us definitely fall in the first category. We definitely love him a lot. And I was fortunate to spend a lot of time with him, you know, got to understand life, you know, how you're supposed to deal with the failures in life, how you're not supposed to give up, and you know, how you keep helping others as to, you know, they perform to the potential that they have got. So thanks a lot, sir. It has been a learning curve for me, and in the coming years also it will always be a learning curve. So thanks a lot, you know, it's a pleasure being here, and you know, it's an absolute pleasure to address all of you on this special evening. So thanks a lot.